This isn't about the
reservation for my daughter's wedding next month, right?
No, we don't do reservations either.
This isn't about real estate. Couldn't be.
We were trying to sell some real estate a while back.
We're not in Dallas though.
Yeah, it's located in Dallas.
I live in Dallas. I'm looking for something right now. That's what it's about. You must have saw my webpage or something. You mind if I ask you 2-3 quick questions? I'm very interested. I'll make you an offer and you can tell me to get lost. Fair?
Yes, that's fair.
That's gut selling.
It is.
I'm sorry. I know maybe we make it look easy, Chris, mm-hmm. but if you're that creative and maybe act a little lost or mm-hmm. a little dopey, or can you help me, sir? I'm so confused. Can you help me? I've got this phone. Anything. I'm sorry it took me so long to get back to you. Why am I calling? Anything, because people love to rescue.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. They love to rescue. Okay. I remember once I was in Chicago with my daughter, totally lost, Michigan Avenue. I went to this nice lady. She looked real nice. And I said, ma'am, can you help me? I am so lost. And she talked for 10 minutes, giving me directions. I couldn't get away. She loved to help.
Yes.
People love to rescue. Back to your role play. Close me up.
All right. yeah, sir, that's very generous of you. And I can see why you would bring that up. You know, you sound like a very smart investor. You want to maybe not take that tax, those capital gains, and maybe spread that out over time. So what if, sir, you know, let's suppose you were able to get, you were able to spread that out over the next couple of years and you'd have like an annuity. It'd be like an annuity. You get monthly income still out on the property, which it'd be like an insurance policy. You'd still be getting monthly cash flow month after month. You get your price and you spread it.
I could do that. If you check, you're going to, if you put, can you put at least 25% down?
If I could put 25% down on the property, what would you say to me next, sir?
I'd say, if you could do 25% down, I'd hold the other, 75% for, 5, 7, 10 years. What kind of interest are we talking about here?
We do, you know, what the banks are doing, we'll do 4% interest.
Oh, no way. I was thinking at least 6.
Okay. At least 6. So I 4, you're thinking 6. Could we meet in the middle on that? 5%, 5.5.
How about 5 the first 3 years, then jump, and then the next 3 years, 5.5%. And then the final 4 years at 6%.
Yeah, you got a deal, sir. You got a deal. Well, I've made a decision, sir. Well,
what? That's so cool. What you just did, very good. Go ahead, close.
I made a decision, sir. We're gonna do business with you, sir. You're gonna get your price. We're gonna skip out capital gains. We're gonna give you 25% down. We'll spread out the interest. It'll go in increments. It'll increase 5.5 to 6% over the period of time, exactly like we just discussed. And then you'll be able to go back to Florida. You'll be on the beach. You'll smell the ocean. You'll smell the fish. Your wife drinking Chardonnay. You're happy in front of the fireplace, and you'll know that this property was taken care of and in the right way. What would you like to do next, sir?
Send me the contract. It's Friday afternoon. I'll look it over. I'll send it right away to my attorney. And why don't we talk next week?
Can you do me a small favor? And time out on the role play, Claude. This is one of those, since I'm discussing like a lot of units, I would need his financials and stuff like that. Should I ask for that now, or should I do that in an email, or what do you think?
Here's the thing. you're in the kill zone right now. You're in that
magic moment.
You're on the mountaintop. You're in that happy place right now.
Right, we're in the magic.
You got the commitment. Now we can fine tune this and all the other little things. But right now, in one phone call, you've negotiated a multi-million-dollar deal on an apartment building with owner financing, with the interest rate for 9-10 years financing. I mean, you are there. So what I would do at this point is maybe in my contract or add a note to my contract, after your attorney approves it and everything, on or before 5 days later, I would need to review the financials and subject to an inspection. Let your contract do the work here.
Okay, yeah, definitely.
Okay, if you get into, right now, one phone call, okay? If you get into the minutiae and everything else like that,
yeah.
Now you're getting bogged down. The girl said yes. The girl said, hey, come in. Would you like a nightcap? Would you like another? You're a married man, so I don't want to get you in trouble. Yeah, what are you gonna say? I'm gonna think about it. Oh, let me talk about this. No, you why not accept yes as an answer and worry about here's my philosophy. I can always fix the other stuff later.
Definitely. Absolutely.
Right now I'm in yes land. I'm right up the ladder.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I got everything. I mean, you can renegotiate everything later if you want. Maybe instead of 9-10 years, you want 15 years and you'll give them 7 or 8%. Maybe instead of amortizing it, principal and interest, maybe you just want to do interest only. Maybe the 25% down, you want to give him 12% now and 12% in 6 months. Everything's negotiable, but yeah. Right now you're in yes land.
Yes. Okay. No, that's why I want to add. That's why I said time out, because I know we're in that magic moment. You got to capitalize on that.
You really do. And congratulations to you, man. You just got, except for the last nail in the coffin move.
Yeah, I'll nail it in the coffin.
And this is the move Chris is going to do right now, because this is when most people in sales get a deal, they get emotionally involved. Oh, I got one. I don't want to do anything to screw it up. And this is exactly when you should get firm and specific commitments for the next meeting, for the return of the contract, or for remorse. You got to deal with the emotion of remorse. So this is the guts post-sell step. Go ahead, Chris.
Absolutely. All right, sir. So could you do me a small favor? I'm going to spend, I had a few appointments today. I had like 8 appointments, 5 phone calls. My daughter, she's turning 5 today, but she'll turn 6 next year. I'll move some things around. I'm just going to take me like an hour to get this together. Can you do me a small favor, sir?
Anything.
After your attorney looks this over, can you get this back to me? Can we talk? Time out.
Let me have a quick time out.
Yeah. How many days?
When you're doing reciprocity, you've got to give me something first before you ask something back.
Okay.
So give me a superstructure. Sir, I got to tell you how much I enjoyed this conversation. I could learn so much from someone like you in the business, and you've been nothing but a gentleman. Thank you so much. Could I ask a small favor? Mm-hmm. You see the move?
Yes, definitely. How much time should I give them? Generally I give people, I say, get it back to me today or the next day, 24
well,
hours.
Well, he said, the guy was very straightforward.
Right.
It's exactly. Friday. He's going to give it to his attorney. I'm playing a pretty sophisticated older businessman.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Sir, could you do me a favor? Could I have the contract back? Do you think Wednesday or Thursday we can get it back from your attorney? Could you do me that? And then I'll contact my attorney. We'll open up escrow and get everything set up. Is that all right with you, sir?
Perfect.
Thank you. This has been a pleasure. Boom.
Absolutely. And then I guess the last post-sale step. Sir, it's been a pleasure speaking with you, sir.
Pleasure's all mine.
I know I can learn so much from you, sir. You're such, I just love doing business with intelligent investors such as yourself, sir.
I'm wet. You're kissed. Oh, God, I'm so wet.
This has been a great and I know you're a man of your word, sir. And your word
I try. I try to, when I make a commitment and everything, if you can do everything you said you're going to do, I see no reason why we can't do this deal.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, and I appreciate that, sir. I appreciate you sharing that with me. And
how did we get together? How did you find me? You've just been driving past my building and you made a cold call. I mean, I like that. I mean, that's how I got this building a long time ago. I met the owner and I just talked to him and I ended up buying the building 30 years ago.
Absolutely. No, I'm your neighbor, sir. I own property in the area. So I was driving by and I saw your building and, you know, I'd like to add that to my portfolio.
Oh, okay. I'd like to. Okay. Yeah. I think I can get you the paperwork back. I'll talk to my attorney, you know, attorneys. I will, one way or the other, let's talk next Wednesday. I'll update you and I'll let you know if we get the contract back by if we can get it back to you by Thursday or Friday. I will stay in the loop here. I won't ghost you.
Oh, well, sir. Yeah. And I know you're a man of your word. And when you cash that check, you know, that's like gold, sir. So when we talk on Wednesday, will you do me a small favor and you just let me say, just tell me yes or no?
I won't do that. Based on my attorney, he may make some revisions and things like that. So if you could write up something, get it to me today. I will get it to my attorney before close of business today. It's Friday. And I'm excited, man. I never thought I'd be able to sell this thing so quickly. And I love the fact when you talked about Florida and everything that, we could actually move to Florida right in January. Mm-hmm. My problems are over and I don't have to pay, 6, 7, 8% to a real estate brokerage.
Absolutely. And I look forward to speaking with you on Wednesday, sir. We'll talk on Wednesday around the same time, around noon. And we'll talk at noon on Wednesday. I know you'll be there on that call because you're a man.
Let's do that. 1 o'clock on Thursday, no matter what.
No. 12 o'clock on Wednesday.
Oh, 12 o'clock. I'm sorry. Yes, absolutely. I'm sorry. I have to go. I got to take my wife shopping. Really nice to meet you, Chris. I'd like to take you and your special lady out for dinner with my wife.
Absolutely, sir. I'd love to do that. I'd love to meet someone like yourself. It's been a pleasure speaking with you.
I'll talk to you then. Boom. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that's guts selling.
Absolutely.
One phone call. This to a lot of people, I tell you right now, do I close everybody? Do I get in? No, sometimes it takes more than one phone call. But I got to tell you, my mentor used to do it. I do it today. I did it the other day. I closed somebody in one phone call with a follow-up phone call. In all honesty, it was two phone calls in one day. Mm-hmm. But I essentially got the commitment and closed them in the first phone call with a follow-up on the financials on the second phone call the same day. That's the million-dollar skill.
That is.
And Chris, you just demonstrated it beautifully, man.
Thank you, Claude. Thank you.
Was that a fast hour or what?
That was a very fast hour. That went by so fast. One other thing, I know you got to go. The pattern in our interrupt that I used in the beginning, I want to write you a very, very large check.
I love it.
You love that one?
I love it. Why? Is money emotional?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
How many people do you think call up investors and say, sir, I'd like to write you a big check today. Sir, are you in the mood on a Friday afternoon to make a lot of money today?
Right.
He's going to go, what, huh? How many times do you think he's ever heard that in his life?
Oh, zero, probably.
And he might laugh. He might say, no, I'm interested. Or he might even lash out at you. This sounds like a scam. I think that's what I did, by the way.
That's what you did. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This sounds scammy, you know, or something like that. But here's the bottom line. What if marketing, which is part of sales, marketing is defined as getting attention.
Yes.
Can I get someone's attention? We're in a world where everybody's texting. They're texting while they're driving, for God's sakes.
Yeah, man.
I mean, people can't pay attention. They're texting on their watch. How hard is it to get somebody's attention, their focus?
Very hard.
You've only got seconds. Okay. And they're used to rejecting people all day long because your competition can't sell. And they waste time with bad marketing and bad VAs and bad acquisition managers and scripts and everything. And you're coming out of left field saying, sir, you're in the mood. Sir, are you Mr. Scott? You in the mood to make a lot of money today? I'd like, my name's Claude Dumb, and I want to make you an offer on your property on 121 Avocado Lane. Boom. He doesn't get phone calls like that.
No, he doesn't. All right.
There's a lot of, there's a lot of drama and emotion and psychology in persuasion. You're on a stage, but you're producing the movie, the theater, you're doing the lighting, the makeup, you're writing the words for that ugly, that word I don't like to use, the script. You're Steven Spielberg. You're producing, you're hiring the actors, everything. This is, you're setting the stage, the environment. And you've only got seconds sometimes to do that, to open the door just a little so that you can come in and learn and have that kind of adult conversation.
Absolutely.
This shit is not easy, but boy, is it worth it. Oh, man.
I know it. You know, it's worth it. This has been some of the best tutelage I've had just in my life in general. This has been.
If people want to reach us, Chris, in Texas to do a deal, what should they do? What's your webpage again?
Yeah, you can find me on Facebook at Chris Scott or type in Mr. Cash Offer for my business page. You can also find me on Instagram at Mr. Cash Offer. And I also have a website, MrCashOffer.com. You can find me on any of those platforms. Twitter, I'm Mr. Cash Offer as well.
And Chris, I'm so proud of Chris. We've been together. I've been mentoring him and teaching him all the dumb stuff I've done so he avoids it and all the things that work. And he's one of these students you love for your teachers out there because this man listens. I love a student that listens because all I want to see is success of my students. And as I always say at the end of every one of my videos, no one deserves success more than you. And that's, that goes for you, Mr. Scott. Thank you to everybody who's listening and watching this. And give, you want to do deals in Texas or maybe some other places, give Chris a call.
Yes.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Claude.